The next thing we're going to do is draw in energy from the ports of your feet, which is why the preliminary work needs to be done on your feet so that those energy ports are open. What's up, guys? It's Cal Marquez. Today I'm going to be talking about how to raise your vibrations and open your chakras. Before I get into the video, I just want to say thank you guys so much for all the support on the channel. I love your faces. So if you're new here, welcome. I'm a very weird dude and I love making this spiritual content. Please consider subscribing and liking the video. I upload at least 2 videos a week, 1 podcast and 1 video just like this. Okay, let's get back into the video. This video serves as the 3rd video in the Mastering Your Energy Masterclass, I guess. It's becoming a thing as we go. In the past videos, we talked about opening up the energy ports in your hands and feet and moving the energy through your body. So you guys should be familiar with the energy body bounce and moving energy through your limbs and spine at this point. What we're going to be talking about next is by far the most important bit of information to all of it. That was unnecessary. I'm sorry. When it comes to energy work, it is supremely important to open your chakras and draw in energy from the earth and store it in your chakras, and that's exactly what we're going to be talking about in this video. So the first technique in this video I want to talk about is the energy circuit. Now this uses all the techniques that you would have learned from the past videos and puts them all together and also stores energy in your subnavel chakra. So to start this technique, get into a meditative position, take your deep breaths, get centered, do what you gotta do to make all the spiritual things happen, and start to move energy through your body. You want to begin with the energy body bounce after doing your preliminary work on the supplementary energy systems. So this is your arms, your legs, things like that. Just get into the flow of everything, move the energy through your spine, and do the energy body bounce for a few minutes. This doesn't have to take long. Starting out, you only need to do this a few minutes. If you're new to it, please watch the older videos and get accustomed to feeling your energy for the first time and moving it through your body. The next thing we're gonna do is draw in energy from the ports of your feet, which is why the preliminary work needs to be done on your feet so that those energy ports are open. Draw the energy up through your legs, up your torso, spine, and bring it up into your head and around to your third eye, and hold the energy there for a minute. And as you're breathing in, continue to breathe in down to the throat chakra, then to the heart, solar plexus, and store the energy in your subnavel. You wanna feel this happening. So the energy should be going up your legs, your back, your head, and then down the front of your body to your stomach, to your subnavel chakra. And feel this energy being stored there. Feel the energy almost pooling and coagulating in that area and storing in that chakra. From there, I take it a bit further from the normal technique, and I take that energy that I just stored and I take another deep breath. And as I'm breathing in, I imagine that energy is flowing up to my third eye, and then I breathe out through the third eye, I breathe in through the third eye, and then I have that energy open my crown chakra and begin to flow out to the chakras above and connect me to universal energy. I do that process at least 5 to 10 times if I'm doing a full energy work routine. A few things that'll happen here: you may begin to feel some overwhelming emotions of joy and love and just bliss, and you may also feel very powerful energy sensations. This is nothing to be afraid of. If you do start to feel the vibrations and start to have a spontaneous astral projection experience, just blank. Don't focus on any of the sensations, just let it happen. Almost just seamlessly move into it, because I found when you focus on the sensations, it messes with the process. This next technique is an in-depth chakra opening technique, and it requires first that you do your overall energy gathering technique where your hands are above your head, or if you're laying down, your hands are above your head. You don't need to have your hands up if you're good at the energy body bounce already. Your hands can be by your side so long as you're feeling the energy moving throughout your body, your arms included. This technique is just like the first. Your feet will need to be planted, and you're drawing energy in from the earth through the ports of your feet. You take that energy up through your legs, and first you hit your root chakra. This is like your perineum area. It's the area right between your anus and genitals, and you focus the energy moving up your legs into that area on your inward breath. And as you're breathing out, focus on the different sensations we talked about in the first video, where we talked about the tearing sensation, the stirring, the brush and the sponge actions. Focus on all of these as you're breathing in and breathing out. And when you're breathing out, focus on your feet again and get ready to draw in more breath as you move back up the legs. For the root chakra, since it is one of the harder chakras to open, try to do this 7 times at least. So bring energy in through the feet and focus it into the root chakra area. After you've done that 7 times, bless that chakra to the highest good and move on to the subnavel and do the same thing only 3 times for the rest of the chakras. Of course, you can do this more if you have a chakra that's specifically closed, or you're experiencing maybe like a cold and you want to focus on your throat chakra a little more. Of course, you can do it more times than that. Now, what I found to be a little difficult is when people are drawing in breath, they're drawing in the breath faster with one chakra and they don't have enough air to breathe all the way in with the other chakras. You can bring chakra into your root area, hold it there as you breathe out, keep your awareness on the root chakra, and as you breathe in again, breathe from the root chakra to the chakras above. And that's how you move through the chakra system. Do this with the other chakras as well, moving from subnavel all the way to crown. And once you've moved to crown, bring your awareness to the chakra right above your head. And this is the chakra of Ra. This is your consciousness, your supreme universal consciousness that feeds you information through the crown chakra. Focus your awareness into that chakra and hold it there for a moment. A lot of different things can happen here, and they are very mystical. If you're in this space, you will feel lots of energy and a divine connection to the universe. Do not be worried if this doesn't happen right away. If you don't feel anything right away, that's okay. I didn't either. You just need to focus on the energy moving through, and as your energy ports open and your chakra systems develop, your abilities will increase and you will feel more of that energy. Again, like I said in past videos, extreme energy sensations just mean that you're clearing out blockages, and you shouldn't be discouraged if the next time you do it, you don't have those same extreme sensations. When I use my energy, it doesn't feel like rushing and explosions or anything like that all the time. It feels like a constant stream of flowing energy that is comfortable and somewhat intense, not horrible. And at this point of your energy work routine, you can use your resonant energy balloon. And basically, this is empowering your aura, cleansing your aura, and using the energy that you've just drawn in to cleanse and basically get you ready for the day or whatever working that you're doing. So for this, you will draw energy in through the feet as you've been doing before. And as you're breathing in, you draw the energy up to your crown chakra. And as you breathe out, imagine that energy siphoning out of your body and creating an aura or like a balloon coming straight from your head. And imagine with every breath that this energy is moving through your feet and going right back up your chakra system through your head and going right back around until you feel that your aura is stable and clean and the energy is flowing almost by itself. And that's going to do it for this video, guys. That should be all the information you need on how to do your own energy work, master your energy, open your chakras, and really start taking advantage of your own energy system. If you enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing and liking so you can see more videos just like this. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please leave them in the comment section. I'm here to help you guys get through these issues and really enjoy your own spiritual power. And every video on this channel is Patreon supported. So if you've enjoyed these series and these videos and the podcast that I've been releasing, and you want that to continue, please consider clicking on the link below and becoming a Patreon. And as always, guys, never stop adventuring.